First of all, I welcome all the esteemed faculty members from school to university level, including National ICT Awardee teachers and professors, assistant professor, associate professors of different universities and school teachers who have genuine interest in teaching of mathematics or presentation of data particularly. And as all of us, we know that we are struggling with a time and fighting with COVID-19. And all the schools and educational institutions of higher learning, so they are shut down due to the COVID-19 effect. And we are saving ourselves, and we are in lockdown and sitting at home and also practicing social distancing. Simultaneously, since students and teachers are also in their respective homes, so it is our concern that we need to interact with ourselves, all the teachers and teacher educators together, and we take forward the teaching learning process. And also, not only that, every time we are associated with teaching, but we need to do our capacity development program of our own and brush up of some of the tools which may require to we may require to use for teaching learning process in our classrooms. So we from 7th of this month we have started the webinar. This will continue this till the shutdown period is there, even beyond. And as a part of this webinar, we have started introducing some web tools and applications which can help us, we teachers and teacher educators, in our teaching learning process and assessment as well. So in the series, we have a presentation today by Mr. Chanchal Das. He is a renowned figure and a teacher trainer also. And we had requested him for coming forward and making a presentation on particularly use of spreadsheet. So it may be Excel, it may be open spreadsheet, and how we can collect data, analyze data, and present data using spreadsheets. So that will be the concern. And I request all our colleagues, nearly 300 people, so you can write on the chat also. And don't say hello, good afternoon, namaste on chat. Straight away you can ask a question or your comments, observation and suggestions. So you can raise your questions on the presentation, because the presentation will continue for 20-30 minutes around. And after the presentation, we'll open it for discussion. But first of all, we'll take all the questions which are asked on chat. So, so far around 50 chat messages are already there. My colleague I have with me, Dr. Nidhi, she will be moderating the session. And I have two of my techie colleagues. One is Mr. Devasis Jaiswal and Madam Sarda. So both of them, they will be providing us technical support. And also I request all of you, you can raise your hand for asking a question also. And we will be pointing to the person who has raised his or her hand and wanting to ask a question. But always the questions, comments and suggestions can be there on chat. We'll be happy if you write there, because it is documented. And we are documenting this video also, and the PPT also, you are going to get this PPT. And we will be uploading this PPT on the webinar page of CIET.NIC.in website, and the video recordings is also being done by my team, and they will upload the video recording also on CIET.NIC.in portal on webinar page. So you need not to be worry about the materials we are going to share. So but try to grasp as much as possible from the resource person and interact with the resource person. For convenience, we have muted your mic, and we will be unmuting when you will be speaking and you have raised a hand to ask a question to the expert. So don't worry, and we will be doing that. And Chanchal Dasji, can you hear me? Chanchal Dasji, can you unmute your audio?
Yeah, I can hear now.
Okay, you are welcome to the webinar. We have 300 plus participants. So I request you to go ahead with the presentation on data, presentation of data using spreadsheets. So it could be open office or proprietary also. And I have a request, there could be not necessarily that it is science or mathematics data. Data is data. So maybe every day how much groceries and vegetables also we are buying, and their analytics for a month also could be data. So even the students in a particular class, if they are 50, 100 and they are learning and if they have performed in a particular way, it is we need to analyze that, it is also data. So how data analysis can be done, and I request Chanchal Dasdi to please give few demo using the application rather than placing the slides. So because these faculty members, they vary from, it is a heterogeneous group, they are from schooling to higher education, you can say nursery to tertiary, so for up to PhD level. So I request you to present in a generic way so that a school teacher and a university teacher, so both of them, they can grasp and they can use this tool as a learning, teaching learning tool and assessment tool for further learning. So with these words, once again I welcome all the participants, 320 plus, and Mr. Chanchal Dasji, who is also a renowned educator and a former engineer, with and he is also bestowed with World Oil Award, so as a thinker. So Chanchal Dasji, then now the floor is with you. We expect a 20-30 minutes presentation from you, then we'll be taking up the question. Dr. Nidhi will be moderating the session, and we have, for your convenience, we have muted the participants' audio so that you can present it nicely, then we will come back with questions, observation, comments and suggestions. So thank you very much once again. Welcome to every one of you. Namaskar. Go ahead. I think Mr. Chanchal Dasji is out from the scenario. So maybe by the time he comes back, let me share some of the ICT initiatives at the national level. Actually, there are many initiatives your child might be interested to know. Can you hear me? All, Dr. Nidhi? Yeah. Dr. Nidhi, you are able to hear me?
Yes, sir, we can hear you properly.
So, if I take you through this presentation till Chanchal Dasji is back. So, actually, we have many ICT initiatives which are in place. So, some of those are Diksha, ICT curriculum, National Repository of Open Educational Resources, massive open and online courses on Swayam, even ePathshala, Swayam Prabha DTH TV channel, bouquet of about 33 channels, so like this. And I would like that some of you must be knowing also, but some of you may not be knowing, even NCERT has developed the ICT curriculum from primary to senior secondary level. We have ICT book also in class 9th and 10th. And 11th and 12th also we have computer science book. But this is a generic ICT curriculum. Suppose I am a science teacher, I am a math teacher, I am a computer science teacher, how using ICT tools I can create, store, retrieve, manipulate, disseminate and share resources with all stakeholders. So that is the main concern. And we have also developed ICT, particularly cyber safety and security guidelines. These are available on CIT website. As a teacher, as a teacher educator, so we need to use this also to be safe on cyber world. Even you might be hearing a lot of news on Zoom also, that there are limitations of Zoom. But if we are using a paid version of Zoom, and also we are using the restrictions part, particularly while using Zoom, so there is less danger in use. But any software can have positive and negative aspect also, but how effectively we use that is essential. And we have a portal called ePathshala. We have around 600 plus books on this portal. And any child of class 1 to 12 can download flip books from this portal, PDF. Also, because nowadays our publication sales counter, we have around 840 book sales counters across the country. Those are closed due to shutdown. So any child at your home or in your neighborhood, they can use this portal and download the book free and use these books also. And similarly, we have also developed a few mobile apps under ePathshala. We have a ePathshala mobile app. All the books also available on your palm through ePathshala. We have four stakeholders: students, teachers, parents, and teacher educators. All digital books, including some B.Ed. books, are also here on ePathshala. Teacher's handbook in three languages: English, Hindi, and Urdu. So you are most welcome. Nearly 28 lakh people are using the ePathshala mobile app, and nearly 10 crore people are using the ePathshala portal. So you could be one of them, and your child is sitting at home and not having a printed book. So definitely you can help your child to download a book and use the ePathshala mobile app. We have branded ePathshala mobile app. You can see from here. We have 8 ePathshala apps. We have a television channel called Kishore Manch. So it is also now carried by all cable operator, including Tata Sky, Videocon, and Airtel. So Tata Sky, it is 756 channel number, and in particularly Airtel, it is 440. So you can use this also for your children, this 24/7 channel. And there are videos. We have developed some performance indicator for teachers. We have also developed a scanner app, because all NCERT books now we have QR codes, and all the QR codes are mapped with e-contents. So using these QR codes, you can scan the code and get the material on the book of your child. Since you don't have physical books now, because your child is promoted or anybody else children are promoted, so you can also use the alphanumeric number here in the QR code to access the content. We have also recently launched a portal called NISTA, National Initiative for School Heads and Teachers Holistic Development. And around 16 lakh teachers we have trained at elementary level using face-to-face program, but monitoring and e-management of the training through the portal called nista.gov.in. Even recently, we have developed an app called ePathshala Augmented Reality. So you can get 3D animations in students' books. So they can scan our 9th, 10th class science book, this color images, and they can see an electric circuit working there, and they can manipulate that also. That we have also done. And also we have a national repository of open educational resources. It is called nroer.gov.in. We are also uploading all the resources. The repository have nearly 17,000 content, nroer.gov.in. This is bit old data, 14,000, but 70,500 contents we have. So it is absolutely free under Creative Commons license. But the textbooks are shared under a non-commercial, non-derivative license, NC by ND license. So you can free use the books from the portal, from the ePathshala portal also. We have also around 33 DTS TV channels, starting from school to higher education level, for all universities, all technical institutes, all departments, even medical and engineering courses. NCERT is also running one channel. It is popularly known as Kishore Manch, because we run programs for adolescent children. So around 39 million views of these programs are also on YouTube, and around 7 lakh plus people, they are watching our channel on JioTV also. This channel is available on all private networks, including DD Free Dish also. So that can be accessed. NCERT has launched around 28 online courses, which can be accessed freely by all of you. We have 70,000 plus learners, but as a teacher, as a student, mostly the courses are for 11th, 12th students, around 22 courses. Remaining 6 courses are for teachers. Even we have a course on action research. Even we have a course for MED, BEd students of education. So that is also there. So this can be accessed from particularly swayam.gov.in portal. And also besides that, I was talking to you about the NISTA portal. So you can find that the NISTA portal look like this, and all the elementary school teachers, they can access content from here, from this portal. And also these are some of the possibilities we can do. Even if you are sitting at home, if you are interested to teach school students and on different subjects, so you can be a TV teacher of NCERT also, and we can TV teacher of NCERT also, and I can or my colleagues, they can contact you and they can teach. You can teach from your home also, and through Zoom or through any other free software. So, and we will carry that forward on live on our channel. So these are some of the initiatives we are doing, but certainly we can join together and also fight against the COVID-19 from our respective homes. So I thought as a stopgap arrangement, I should share some of the things with you. And some of you have raised your hands. So Rigendra ji has raised his hand. So I think I should connect to him and ask him what is the question. So Rigendra ji, you can speak now.
Thank you, sir. This is a nice program. And first of all, I would like to introduce myself. Myself, Mrigendra Kumar, Assistant Professor, Mahila College, Saharsa, Bihar. And I was a student of Dr. Senapati, sir, also. He had taught me in MED class, sir. So this is so greatness for me. And sir, actually, I'm doing action research program, but right now we are not getting the action research topic. I had sent it, but not but checked, sir. So this is my question. And
sir, can we, sorry to interfere, but can we have the we can have questions related to this webinar in this webinar session. Rest of the questions you can ask somewhere else. Later on, maybe you can call those who are responsible for conducting the action research program.
Here we have to ask only related to webinar, na?
Yes, yeah. Sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Vigendraji. Thanks for coming and sharing your experience.
Sir, thank you.
We will get back to you.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you. And now, Madam K. Anita. So, I think...
Sir, I guess Chanchal Das, sir, he has logged in again.
He's back. Yeah.
So can you hear us? So
who is Vivo 1804? Please rename yourself, sir, because we don't know who are you.
Sir, I am Dr. Neelagandan from Trichy, Tamil Nadu.
Hello, Vanakkam.
Sir, Vanakkam, sir. I'm so happy about you, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir, I would like to know the things which we can provide or which we can create some online courses to the students. So what are the ways to create some new videos to online?
Okay, so we will be talking about that. There are
create online videos. What are the tools can be used?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
OpenShot video editor also is a tool. You can edit that also, and you can record from any mobile, sir. There are many tools, but as a free tool, OpenShot video editor, you can use for editing videos. You have recorded using your mobile phone also.
Okay, sir. Sir, and one of my friends who is asking that, So these kind of programs will definitely would enhance them themselves, and they can hone their skills also. In addition to that, they request that they need kind of a certificate. So would you provide that?
Yeah, yeah, sure. We'll discuss further. Thank you very much, Nandri. So we'll get back to you.
Nandri, sir.
Okay. So now, much. Madam K. Anita.
Hello, sir. This is Anita.
Anita ji, namaste.
Sir, are you
listening? Your voice is very poor. You have to come closer to the mic and speak slowly.
Namaste. Sir, I am from Jaitya district. I am mathematics, sir.
You are from which district?
Okay, sir. Sir, I am Mahit. Jagikyal, Telangana. Jagikyal, sir. Yeah, sir.
Namaste.
Sir, sir, I just completed my MEd and MSc psychology, sir.
Yeah.
Is there any option, sir? Is there any, will you suggest any online course, sir?
Actually, we have a PG diploma course in guidance and counseling, educational guidance and counseling. Definitely, we'll share the link with you and you can go ahead with doing that. All the best, Anita ji.
Okay, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. I think these were Vijay Gupta ji. I would like to ask a question. Vijay Gupta ji, Punjab se. Daso ji.
Yes, sir. Jai Hind, sir.
Namaste, Vijay ji.
Namaste, sir. Sir, actually,
Vijay ji, keep your system in mute position. Mute.
Actually, sir, I want to know some kind of a free platform, open source, to create a online quiz so that we can put on them on our blog or our website portal.
Okay.
Actually, Google form is good, but there is a restrictions. Suppose I have 10 or 15 Google forms, so students can do only one.
You have tried Mentimeter?
Yes, actually there is so pricing and paid, and there is so complication is there.
No, for Mentimeter, it is free, so okay. You can do the develop also. So not necessary that you have to pay. Mentimeter, you can do many activities. So not only quiz, you have many open-ended activities also you can do. Quiz is a closed-ended activity. So,
okay, sir.
Yeah, yeah. We will share some of the other platforms for developing quiz. So even Dilip ji also shared one platform for developing quiz. So we can have many more. We'll share some of the other platforms.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, Vijay ji.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Sir, I think Chanchal Das sir has joined us.
Can we?
Chanchal sir, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear.
We can hear you, sir. Please start. Yeah,
please go ahead. Don't worry about your presentation.
Yes, so
I'll do that.
And you can only use the particularly spreadsheet from your computer. Don't use the presentation.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Go to the spreadsheet.
Yes, I am trying to open my what file, and from that I.
But speak something, then open. Don't straight away go so that you will be struck.
Yeah. Actually, can you see my screen?
Yes, sir. Everybody can see your screen.
Yes.
Please
now I will be explaining why many people are asking what software they should use for IT and all these things. I am telling that this Excel, MS Excel, these all files are created in MS Excel, and this can be done for all the mathematics you teach in school and from our education and PhD level. I do all those things in for abstract algebra, coordinate geometry, complex algebra, anything you name, I do that. So this is one axis I have created. I am showing a perspective view, how the perspective view is created from a 3D object. 3D object is a three-dimensional object which having X, Y, Z, and when we transform it, it becomes a 2D object, and how this process goes on. that I am explaining here, I have put another plane at zero, z is equal to zero plane, and another plane at my eye level, I have put another plane, and then I have put a cube. Now from this cube, I am seeing from my eye, and how this object will, what will be its perspective view, that we teach engineers, but we don't have any.
Chanchal Dasji, you have to share your screen. Your screen is not yet shared.
I am sharing now. You can't see the screen.
No, sir. No. You have not probably
you
shared.
You have not
your
shared.
Screen.
Go to share green button.
Okay. I will do that.
So I think the connect is disconnected or so.
Yes, I think probably. Actually, there is internet problem, and he has very large number of slides that he has.
Slides. You should tell him that he should not use slides. He can straight
away. I have already told
to
him,
the,
sir, to use Excel sheet, open Excel, and then or use with pen and paper if he can explain a bit. So
yeah.
Let's see if he.
Maybe if few hands are raised, we can take some questions. Rajkumar ji, who is Mr. Rajkumar?
Sir, vanakkam.
Vanakkam. How are you?
Yes, sir. I am fine, sir. I met you in ICT Mela, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yes, I have one doubt, sir.
I cannot see you.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have one doubt, sir. In Pondicherry, most of the schools we have ICT lab. In ICT lab, we have more than 20 computers in the ICT lab. What our idea is, how to conduct the online assessment for the students. Because the online assessment is paper-free assessment, so we can save more stationaries. I learned about H5P and Moodles. But all these software are H5P is a free software. We are using it. But it need an internet connection for the operation. If our CIT develop one software like H5P, and we have the open without internet connection, we can perform. If it is an offline tool, it will be very useful, sir. So we can design the quiz in our home and take it to the school and keep it in the main server. From the main server, it will go to the 20 computers. So each and every student will operate it. It will be very much useful. Even without internet connection, we can conduct online assessment, sir. Will CIT take initiate, or whether any such tool is available in off working in offline mode, please communicate to us, sir. It will be very helpful.
Yeah, definitely we'll let you know. And I must thank you, Rajkumar ji. And you are already using some proprietary and free mix tools for quizzes and assessments and cumulative assessments. So it is good to know that you are already doing, but Moodle has a offline version also, it can be done. So it can work in intranet also. So within the school campus, it can also be used, and a couple of systems can be mapped, and we can have a link among the systems. So, and it can be used offline also. So besides that, on NROER, particularly NROER, we have a large data, and we are working on an offline version of NROER. So that all the resources are given to a school, so they can take all the resources and they can use the resources. We have already come out with some solutions using Colibri. There is one agency from Ahmedabad, Research Foundation. So we are working with them. As soon as it is done, we'll be coming back to you. So that every teacher can use that offline also.
Okay. Sir, one more, sir. What is Mentimeter, sir? How can we get it, the Mentimeter?
You can go to menti.com site. You can register on a Google ID or any social media ID also, and you can create quizzes also, and very interesting. You can see even Mentimeter you can use as a training tool also. Suppose I would like to have a brainstorming. If you want, I can demonstrate also instantly. Let me find 1 or 2 minute time in between. I can also demonstrate. We can have online brainstorming on any particular theme. How spreadsheet is useful? We can have a word cloud showing that all the 300 plus people they are responding and all their responses are visible there. So there are many features of Mentimeter. So you can use that as well. Send a slide mentioning that how you can register and how you can use that for developing quizzes also.
Sir, we'll be very thankful, sir, if you do one day webinar class on Mentimeter. So every participant will learn about the Mentimeter. So it will move to next level, sir.
Working
in Moodles is very difficult, sir. It has more icons. The inputting question is also very difficult. So please teach us a Mentimeter, sir. Thank you for giving this opportunity, sir. Thank you for CIT and NCERT. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Rajkumar ji, Nandri.
Nandri, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. So after Rajkumar ji, Chandan Das ji is back. Mr. Maruti Sharma ji.
Sir, I want to say something about a spreadsheet.
Sir, continue. We are just making a stopgap arrangement. Unfortunately, your system stopped in between a couple of times. I am extremely sorry for that. And also, I feel sorry for 370 people there waiting. So, please go ahead, Chandan Das ji.
No issue, sir. I am not opening my presentation. I am just trying to share my experience with Excel worksheet. Actually, what I feel that anything you can do with Excel spreadsheet, anything. And I am doing it not for my education one objective, but I was looking for why we fail to understand mathematical concept. For that, I was trying to do something. And now what I am doing, I am trying to do everything in physical model. And then trying to do that physical model into mathematical model with using a spreadsheet. And everything I am doing, I am giving some examples for that. Just I will show some videos. This is my 3D coordinate system, what I should say. This coordinate system, when we demonstrate any engineer a 3D view, how this 3D view looks like, so we cannot see that actual shape. The visual thing is different than what is actual. Visual thing, they get conversed. They get, when we stand in between two lines, it get conversed and meet a point like that. Horizon is there. When we stand somewhere, we feel that everything is meeting the sky in a line. All this concept, while we stand, for that we use this. This is another concept for explaining homogeneous coordinate. Homogeneous coordinate, these two, you can say that parallel lines, these are the parallel lines. So these parallel lines goes infinitely, but when we see in between these two lines, no, we feel that this line two is converging to a point. And beyond that, there is nothing. So how, where it converges, where it meets, all this explanation in, we do this in this, and this explanation can be done in this Excel worksheet using homogeneous coordinate system. Homogeneous coordinate system is not taught in school or colleges. There is a great gap. If somebody knows what is homogeneous coordinates, life will be become very, very, very simple. Even IITs, they are not teaching homogeneous coordinate system. And that also we do it with using a spreadsheet. So this is one thing I want to promote to throughout the schools. Our student, class 7-8 student, they can learn PhD level mathematics if they learn this homogeneous coordinate system. That I am trying to prove. And this takes only 2-3 days only. And I ask the government that give me access to the students that I will go without homogeneous coordinate system explaining the 3D phenomena and others using software will not help. means I am a researcher. I am from my research. I have seen for learning mathematics, I learned fast 3D maths, which is 3D animation used for cinema, making cinema. Then I learned MATLAB. But all those things will not help until unless you know the homogeneous coordinate system. And that is my, I have applied patent for that. Once a student are clear about what, and all the teachers, I should say similar way, if they have this tool, homogeneous coordinate system, they can explain by doing everything. I will show that this is some four-link mechanism. This four-link mechanism, when you can see that, this is the physical model. And every link, every point of this link, they are creating some graph, curve. This curve, how this shape will happen? This will happen, this kinematics, when you will go teach, they will intuitively go on reading what actually happens, why this take particular shape, they never understand. The physical model, and with that Excel model, they can generate all these graphs, you can see.
Sir, sorry to interfere you, but yeah. Can you open not your presentation, but a separate Excel sheet where you can put few numbers and
actually, what is happening when I'm trying to put my screen? No, I'm getting this.
It's a screenshot because so people want to know what.
Yeah, I wanted to show
but,
that.
But to tell everyone, when he's sharing the screen, immediately this computer is getting switched off.
Yes.
So
yes.
That is the
actually,
problem.
The network
okay,
is poor.
Put another session for that. I will be happy to know that. I know that.
We will have to print the presentation.
Dr. Nidhi, Chanchal Dasji, can you do one thing? Chanchal Dasji, you
yes.
can give some instruction how to use a spreadsheet for a particular purpose. We will request one of our participants if they are conversant with the spreadsheet and they can try your situation on their screen and they can show it to us. Can
okay.
we share their screen and they will? So anybody will raise the hand who can do work on spreadsheet situation to be given by Chanchal Dasji?
Yeah, I can say that, sir. We teach
can you
calculus.
Give a simple problem so that one of us can try that and show from their screen. You can give a simple problem which anybody can do using a spreadsheet. Yeah.
Should I do or somebody?
No, you have to give a problem and one of the participant they will work on spreadsheet and they will show you.
Okay. Suppose I am having a function y is equal to x square. I want its derivative to be explained in using a spreadsheet.
So two people have volunteered, I guess, Mr. Pramod and Ms. Chandni Agarwal. So I think they can do.
Madam
just
Chandni Agarwal, we can go to Madam Chandni Agarwal and she can show it and share her screen.
Sir, let me try it in my Excel file if it works.
Your network is very poor. We can see from your video also.
Okay.
So your internet connectivity is poor. That is why again and again it is closing.
Yes.
Because
okay. Then I can.
The bandwidth is not there.
I can show some function and its derivative. Okay.
It's okay. Don't worry. We need to understand the concept and how difficult situations can be done. Madam Chandni has come forward. Yeah, so she will do on the basis of your instruction. Madam Chandni, please go ahead.
Yeah, can I access her screen?
No, you need
yes,
not
sir.
To do anything. She will be
okay.
doing only. You have to give instruction.
Okay, okay.
Sir, you give me instructions. I'll go step by step.
Okay, sir. Can I see your screen?
Sir, is this visible? Is my screen visible?
No. You have to see, share once again.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you try once again?
Yes, ma'am.
Now it is
coming.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
okay.
Great. Chanchal Dasji, your instruction starts.
Okay. Madam, you take x is a dependent independent variable, so you can take x value, suppose minus 2, you enter minus 2 and next cell is equal to not like that. Can we work up that?
Sir, are we going to write formula?
Yes.
Tell
below
me.
Below that, below this.
Below minus okay. 2, you have to write.
Okay, okay.
I think I can do that. From
sir, you tell me the formula, please.
Don't worry, Chandan Das ji. You can tell the formula.
You can go to B3 cell, the above cell.
Okay.
Plus 0.1. Plus 0.1. So you are incrementing this previous value and then go to the drag it up to plus 2. Drag it up to plus 2. Up to plus 2, you do that. Okay. Go back. And next column, you take next column. Y is equal to next column heading y is equal to x cube. Let us take a cube function x cube. X3 you put. Come to this next row. Next cell. Next cell is equal to select previous cell. Previous cell. Power 2 to the power 3. Make it to the power 3. B cube to the power 3, shift and 6, shift and 6, that also you can do, that select these two, 3, yes, you that can. And then select that formula, right click, yes. Now, select both the line, both the rows, both the columns, select both the columns, not X, Y, heading not required, only data.
Okay.
You do the data, first row B and row C, only data you select. Yes. Now go to insert, scatter charts, their chart, this is chart. Yeah, it will work, okay. Make it okay.
Chandan
Das
ji,
aapka
awaaz thoda excellent.
So, okay. Now we got suppose we want to
you want to come closer to the mic and slowly explain, because many of our viewers, they are saying your voice is not clear.
Okay, now suppose we want to calculate the derivative at x is equal to 1.5. x is equal to 1.5. There you want to calculate derivative and want to show that how this derivative looks like. That is also another objective. So what we will do, we will take a cell like you go ahead.
Okay. Sir, in which cell?
D of 2, 3, 4 something somewhere.
Okay, should I remove this chart or keep it here?
Chart you take closer, now leave about chart. Chart is not required now.
Okay.
Now we will concentrate how to calculate that derivative. You come to E.
Okay.
Here heading you give X and then F
is... Thoda slow boliye so that people can hear you properly.
Okay.
So,
X heading is X.
And again. Loudly also, slightly loudly.
X equal.
Okay. X. And then F in F column, you make it Y. Y. And same, take any value, X is equal to 1.5 below X. 1.5. Yes, 1.5. And then same formula you can copy from here. You can select that C3 cell, right click, copy, and we can paste it till same formula will come. I think 1.5 is, yes, it is okay. So this is the function, okay? I want to calculate the derivative at this point. So what we do in actual case, we take H as an increment. So H will be taking here a values. So next cell below 1.5 you take is equal to previous cell plus 0.1. So we are incrementing, or 0.001 or 0.0001, you can make add simple. So then click on this F3, click on F3 and corner, click it corner, yes. So this is the thing. Now here you give the heading at G2, heading you put G2 delta X, dx. So come here at G4 you come. G4. So is equal to E4 minus E3. Minus E3. It is the your dx. Then next you go here dy. And is equal to similar formula F4 minus F3. F4 minus F3. Yes, so dy by dx. So next you heading you give dy by dx. So is equal to come down. Is equal to that is equal to this cell by, divided by this cell. So this is the derivative at 1.5. Okay. Now what is that mean? It is 2x actually. It will come somewhere 2x something. But what does it mean? We have to show that geometrically. So for that, what we will be doing, we know that this dy dx represents a line which is slope, slope of that line. So we have to draw that line. So how to draw that line? That is the trick. Once we can do that, then they will be showing, see that yes, any derivative means this. So we want to create a straight line, which is the tangent line. So what we'll do, we go next ij cell, you go next cell, you go right, yes, you go further right. So here we got, you see here three things are there, x we know, y we know, del x y know. So a straight line, have any straight line, if you have to draw, you require two parameters. So we the line we want to draw, we know that one parameter, what is that? M, this is slope. But another parameter we should know, then we can draw that straight line. So that what will be available from this data, we can calculate the C means the y intercept. So come here at J4, you can write here C, so that's C is y in, C. So here we will calculate is equal to C formula, y is equal to mx plus C, that formula, no? The same formula we will use C is equal to y is equal to mx plus C, then C is equal to y minus mx. So first you have to select y, this is your y formula, this is your y, this cell. Upper wala. F3.
One second. Which one, sir?
F3. Y minus M.
Loudly boliega.
ठीक है, I'm try कर रहा हूँ.
So that they can understand.
Okay.
Y multiple.
Minus. Now Y minus MX. Y minus MX is equal to C. So X is this.
This one.
Into M is this. M is means dy dx.
This.
Yes. Is equal to, you click. So this is, you got two parameters, M and C. So once you have two parameters, you can draw any line. So this will be our tangent line. So now what will be that? One point already we have. Y is equal to C is equal to Y. Yes, you are right. Okay. Now for tangent line, we require again at least two point is required to draw a line. We have one point and we require to get another point. So how to get that another point? So for that, what we'll do here, we take x and y again, k2 column, it is x, but this x is for tangent line, not that function line, a function. And why you take next cell? Why? Ah, yes. And similarly, why for tangent line? And this, when a student learn this, no, this much Thomas Finney books, all are full book is only using this formula. One formula, they have full graphs. They can solve any problem. Why you take, you go right, let it come back. You go right further. Right. Yeah, like that. So now here K4 is equal to K4 come to K4 is equal to this point is there. Here F4 is our X. F or J. So that point we will take 1.5. That point is already we have 1.5. Yeah. E3. Yes. So this point is there. Enter. Simple enter. Enter. Then Y is equal to this is equal to this cell. Okay.
Sir, Y equal to this one, F3?
Yeah, yes. F3, yes, enter. And just go right so that you can have some space. People can see what is there. Why? Now we require another X and to draw that line. So another X. This X is independent variable. No, here. K3. We can take arbitrary interval. So is equal to this X. Minus some 1 or 2 you can take this cell K4 select K4 minus 2. 2 means arbitrarily I am taking a point left side to this point and below another point K5 you come is equal to this K4 plus 2. I am taking another point rightward. Now here is the trick. Here in L3, you go to L3 is equal to here we have M, X and C. We are calculating Y. So Y is equal to MX plus C. So this is X, this is M and this is C. Is equal to, you select this one, K3, yes, into M, you go to left, I, left side, yeah, this is M. So which select one? This, MX,
MX.
This is M, no?
I4.
I4. Okay. Plus J4. C is J, this one, J4. Plus, is equal to C, enter. So one point I have received. And then same formula we'll be using for this point, 3.5 formula, 3.5. So come back, no, you have to, is equal to, you take K5 into X, this is X and this is M, MX, I4. Plus J4.
Actually, Chanchal Das ji, thoda sa simple ye figure aane ke baad, so please try some simple analytics so that everybody can understand because there is a generic audience who are watching.
This will enjoy. I am doing something. It is that big book of Somas Pileva Stewart book, no? Only one formula a student learn properly, he can solve. Even class 8, 10 student can solve this much volume of calculus. This is the rule.
Okay.
Okay. So this is very important formula I am trying to show. Now what we'll do, we will go to the figure. We are now having x and y, we'll just plot it. So we'll plot it in that figure. You now drag that figure. Where is that figure? No, not insert. Already we have figure. Where is that figure? This figure you drag here. Row AB. Okay, you can keep here. No issue. Yes. Okay. Keep it like that. Okay, keep it like that. And now right click on drag. And select data. So here we will add legend entries, no series data. Here you can add one select data source has come, no? In that, you select that x, all three values of x. Three values of x have come. Then, edit. You click on edit. Click on edit. Here, edit. And you have put y values. Yes, okay, make it okay. Okay. Then where is that your original graph?
Sir, it is overwritten.
How it will overwritten? This series should be there.
One second.
This is here you right click.
This graph is here.
You right click on this graph.
Okay.
And select data.
Select data, right?
Add series.
Yes.
No, not edit. Cancel.
Sir, cancel. It will add. It is added.
No, it will not add. It will edit. Means original.
Sir, see, if I click on add, it will add. Although it will add, but it is showing the title edit.
Now select range. Series. Select range. Okay, I got it. Okay.
And now I'll select X range.
Now X. X is not required, only data you can select.
Then I will take Y values.
Yes, you are right. And then?
Then we will say okay.
Okay. So you remove that header. Header you have included, no? Edit. You can go to edit.
Okay.
You can edit. And header, it means this should be K3 to K5. Yes. K3. L3, enter, okay. Now this is actually dy/dx, but hardly many students that we tell y is equal to x cube, x is equal to y cube, what will be the derivative? So people will say 3x square, we will get some value, but what is that value? This is the value of this slope of this line. So this geometrically, now we can animate it. If you want, we can animate it for every point. You can see it is touching at one point, this is tangent line.
Chanchal sir, can we take few questions on this? Can we make it online if or share it with some other things possible? Or can you just tell us how in statistics or in other subjects can it be useful, this technique?
My experience I should share. I am a mechanical engineer, so I was scared about mathematics, so that was my journey. Because in school days, during engineering career, I never faced any problem, but in school days I got a
hello.
Anji sir, yes sir.
Chanchal Das ji, I think his signal is lost. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Can we take few questions, Dr. Nidhi? Because time is
already up. Yes, sir. Yes,
sir, actually, if I can help you next, sir.
Chandini ji.
Maybe Chandini ma'am can help us.
Yes, if there is an. Thank you so much, sir. It's my pleasure. Yes.
I'll pause the screen.
We would have collaboratively done that also, because this tool collaboratively can be worked on by few people also. That is also possible. Yeah.
Sir, is there any question of Excel I can answer?
Please, yes, ma'am. Somebody is asking that how can we use Excel for data mining if it's possible?
Can you close this share screen? Stop it so that people can see each other.
One second, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Can it be used for data mining? How Excel can be used?
Okay. In Excel, can I share my screen again? Just tell about some options of Excel.
No, data mining means what do you want? So you want to store some data, or data mining is a storage part you are talking?
See, we can do extensive data analysis using many formulas. Actually, I can't give this answer in particularly by giving example how we can mine our data and all. But here many functions are available like lookup and referencing. So we can use pivot table for data mining, hlookup and lookup function and vlookup. So these functions basically help us to arrange our data, to analyze our data quickly and in analytical way. So these are the basically pivot table helps us.
And ma'am, can you just suggest few ways in which maybe these things can be used in some other few other subjects?
Analyzing our result, we can use. And I'll just tell this conditional formatting part. This is also very helpful in analyzing the data. In economics, we can apply we can use in mathematics. So wherever we need calculation and we need the graphical part, we use Excel there. And we can make extensive use of this conditional formatting. I'll give you small example of using conditional formatting by just writing a simple example of students.
And ma'am, maybe in statistics also? Statistical analysis.
We can apply. First, we can write formula. Any formula we can write. If we can take, suppose example of choices of people, like how many people are...
Ma'am, we can't see your screen. We can just see your face.
Okay, I'll just...
If you're trying to show something then.
Yes. Okay. I think it's visible now.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So, if they are asking about the market choice of people and they are using, say, they like fashion trends for few people, and few people they need to say eating is their choice, music is their choice. So, here if I am entering some numbers, say male and female. So if I write here like 200, suppose 20 male are interested in fashion and 50 females are interested, or 35 males and here 15 female are interested in this part, and say 10 and that here data is say 30. So if I want to apply conditional formatting, so I'll simply select, go to conditional formatting, and we can apply data bar here. So we can apply data bar, we can apply solid data bar. So in this way, graphical representation comes on the cell also. Then we can use color sets. We can use icon sets, like wherever increase, decrease. So this such kind of icons we can set along with our data. We can create more rules accordingly. So if I go to more rules, it will be going to very detail. That one more session we can take up for managing rules and all. One we use for result analysis is highlight cell rules. Like if I want to highlight a cell greater than, so I'll write here the value greater than, say, 40. So one second. So if I want to highlight cells with the value greater than 40. And suppose there is no value greater than 40, I'll take 30. So I can change the custom border and custom format for cell. And simply I can select any format, or I can create my customized format and highlight the cell. So in this way, my cells are highlighted according to my data analysis. Plus here we can have top 10%, bottom 10%, above average, below average, everything is there once you have your data with you. So this conditional formatting tool is very, very helpful for filtering out the data. And one more tip I want to give here is sometimes when we say, when we apply data filter here, suppose I apply here data and apply here filter. So if I am filtering out the choice of say two choices, say fashion and music, and I want to only see these two things. So when I copy the data and I only want to copy only visible cells, right? So I'll go to home, I'll go to find and select. I'll increase my cell size just to demonstrate. Go to special and then say visible cells only. So this option, many people, they don't know. And when they select the filter data and when they copy this data and paste at another place, the entire data is copied, including all the cells. So if we want to just copy down the visible cells, so we will just copy just option on this option, visible cells only, and then say okay. When you copy this data, it will only copy visible cells, the selected portion.
Yeah. Ma'am, can you suggest quickly, I mean, we have to wind up now. Suggest any online tool or any tutorial on the same that the concept which has discussed today?
I'm writing here GCF Learning. If we Google exact like address, I don't remember. But if you go for GCF Learning site, so it gives a hands-on tutorial on GCF Learning site.
Okay.
For Microsoft Excel, any version. We have to select the version.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. I think we should stop here now. We have already exceeded some time.
Okay,
I would like to wind up now.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So for me, just last point, in Excel, you can do anything. And for learning mathematics and science concept, this is the best tool. And once you know that homogeneous coordinate system, otherwise these tools means it's a game changer. Nobody
has been involved. Maybe we will have your video sessions on our TV channel so that you can use a board, digital board, and use rather than your internet connectivity. So thank you very much for sparing your valuable time. We are extremely sorry due to bad network. We could not have better interaction using your share screen, slide share. And also I thank Chanchal Dasji once again for agreeing to take this session online. And I also thank Madam Chandni Agarwalji, National ICT Awardee, for supporting. And also I thank all of you for actively participating. I am extremely sorry. There could be some concepts which may not be related to your subject area. But these were some of the concepts and tools which we can use as a teacher educator, given you have the responsibility to use this. Otherwise, also data analytics or presentation tools are helpful for any subject teacher, not necessarily for math teachers. Like Madam Chandni Agarwalji is a computer science teacher, but still she requires data analytics and tools to represent data. There are many free open source tools also, even Ubuntu, Kubuntu, Linux operating system based spreadsheets are also there. So it is up to you. But since Chanchal Dasji was more convergent with the Excel, so we thought to present that. But there are free open source tools also that you can try. And I request all other participants to help each other. And the presentation along with the video recording will be uploaded on CIET website. So maybe after 24 hours, you can see that presentation we can upload today. Yeah, we will request Chandan Chanchal Das ji to reduce the presentation size and share with us. We are extremely sorry for barging into your time. 15 minutes almost we have taken. And maybe some other questions which people raise their hand, because I could see few of you raised your hand. Mr. Balraj Nuthipalli, Madam Harpreet Kaur. So we could not take your questions. Adhi Kesavan R, Madam Padmaja. So Anjali Sokin, we could not take your questions, but do write on the chat platform. We will analyze it, keep it for next session. Since we are already late by 15 minutes, you must be having other engagements also. So please catch us tomorrow also. So we'll have another interesting session through webinar. And there are some people, they have raised questions of getting a certificate. We are thinking to issue certificate to those who have at least out of 30 sessions participated in 15 sessions, and we'll be issuing badges for each webinar, those who have participated. So don't worry, and let us be a teaching community and spread ICT tools and help people to stay at home and learn from home and fight with COVID-19. So with these words, once again, I thank you all the participants, especially the academic fraternity, those who have joined, and also Chanchal Das ji, Madam Chandni Agarwal, my colleague Dr. Nidhi, and Devasis and Sarda for technical support. So thanks to one and all. Namaste.